Hi, I'm John, and in this ittaster video, I'm going to help you get to grips with binary. I'm going to do that using a Raspberry Pi computer, some simple electronics, and a vintage computer from the 1980s. So if you're new to binary, or even if you have a good understanding already, then hopefully this video will make you think of binary in a different way. Binary has been around for a very long time, way before the invention of the modern computer. And when we think of the inner workings of a computer, we think binary and talk of the ones and zeros going on behind the scenes. But in order to understand what's really going on and where binary comes into play, we need to take a step back and begin with some simple electronics. If I push the switch, I can switch the LED on or off. And that's it. The LED has only two states. Electrical current either flows or it doesn't flow. And this is all the pioneers of digital computing had to work with. Two states, on and off. And much of what goes on inside a computer involves a great deal of switching on and off. In the world of digital electronics, the on and off states are referred to as high and low. In the computing world, we use binary to represent these two states. The bi in binary, of course, means two. And binary consists of only two numerical symbols, 0 and 1, which makes it ideal to represent the on and off states needed for digital computing. The off state is represented by a 0. And the on state is represented by a 1. In binary, this is called a bit, which is short for a binary digit. Now, only being able to work with two numerical symbols is somewhat restrictive. Performing simple tasks like representing numbers other than 0 and 1, or counting, need to be approached differently to the way human beings do things. And this is really key to understanding binary. To help understand how we represent binary numbers, and even count in binary, it's time to dust off a vintage home computer from the 1980s. Because it has something that modern computers don't, a cassette recorder. Back in the 80s, the cassette recorder provided a means for storing data. But the thing I'm interested in is the cassette counter. The cassette counter has three wheels. Each wheel has 10 digits, 0 to 9. It counts in the same way we do. The wheel on the right represents units 0 to 9. The middle wheel represents tens, 0 to 9, and the wheel on the left represents hundreds, 0 to 9. Let's load a piece of software so we can see the counter in action. The counter begins to count. Now notice what happens when the units wheel goes past 9. The next wheel representing tens will move to 1 and the units wheel will reset and go back to 0. And the count starts over again. Now the important thing to note is when a single wheel has reached the maximum value it can display, 9 in the case of the vintage computer's cassette counter, the next wheel comes into play to carry over the value each time 10 is reached, and the count begins again. This is exactly the same principle that is applied to a binary counter. And to demonstrate this, I'm going to use a Raspberry Pi computer and some electronics. I'm using a Raspberry Pi Model B Plus, and I've connected 4 LEDs to the GPIO general input output port. I've written some Python code that counts in decimal and then converts the decimal value to binary, which is output to 4 LEDs. Each LED represents one binary digit, one bit, which can be set to on or off. Now if we cast our minds back to the vintage computer's cassette counter, the wheel on the far right represented units, the middle wheel tens and the left wheel hundreds, the deanery system we humans are used to. In binary, we have to approach things differently. Because we don't have 10 digits to work with, we only have 2 digits, 1 and 0. The LEDs can be switched on or off. So the values we assign to each LED, each bit, must reflect this. The values assigned to each bit are 1, 2, 4 and 8. A good way to understand the reason for this is to simply count in binary. The first bit represents 1s. It can display 0 when the bit is set to off, and 1 when the bit is set to on. 1 is the maximum number the first bit is able to display. In order to count beyond this to the next number, 2, we need to carry over to the next bit, the 2's bit. The 1's bit resets and goes back to 0 to begin again, just like the wheel on the cassette counter did when it reached 10. To display 3, the 1's bit is set to on and the 2's bit is set to on. 2 plus 1 is of course 3. We've now reached the point where the 1's bit has reached the maximum number it's able to display, and also the 2's bit. So the counter must carry over to the 4's bit, and the 2's bit and the 1's bit reset to 0 again. The 1's bit is set to on, and the 4's bit is set to on to represent 5. The 1's bit has reached the maximum number it's able to display. So we carry over to the 2's bit, and the 1's bit resets to 0. 4 plus 2 is of course 6. You get the idea. And this process continues until all of the 4 bits are set to on. The highest number our 4-bit counter is able to display is 15, 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1. Our 4-bit counter has run out of road. In order to deal with larger numbers, we need to add more bits. I've added another 4 bits, and we now have 8 bits to work with. The values assigned to the first 4 bits are of course the same as before. 1, 2, 4 and 8. And we simply continue by doubling the value assigned to each bit. 16, 32, 64 and 128. 8 bits is known as a byte, whereas 4 bits, half a byte, is known as a nibble. A byte is needed to represent an alphabetic character. If we were to count to the maximum value the 8-bit counter can display, we'd be here a little while. The maximum value the 8-bit counter is able to display is 255. And I'll show you how to calculate that and how to convert a binary number to decimal. To convert a binary number to decimal, I'm going to turn to the Raspberry Pi again and ask it to generate a random number. All we have to do is add together the value of each bit that is set to 1, each LED that is on, which is 128, plus 64, plus 16, plus 4, plus 2, plus 1, which equals 215. Let's do one more. Again, we need to add together 128 plus 16 plus 1, which equals 145. So to work out the maximum number our counter is able to display, all we have to do is assume every bit is set to on. So we simply add 128 plus 64 plus 32 plus 16 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1, which equals 255. Okay, now that we know how to convert a binary number to decimal, let's look at how to convert a decimal number to binary. I'm going to use the Raspberry Pi again, and this time I've written a small piece of code to generate a random decimal number for us to convert and then output as a binary number. The decimal number the Raspberry Pi has generated is 41. To convert a decimal number to binary, the first thing we need to do is find the largest bit value that will go into the decimal value, which is 32. And we set the bit representing 32 to 1. We then need to subtract 32 from 41, which equals 9, and repeat the process again until we reach 0. The largest bit value that will go into 9 is 8. So we need to set the bit representing 8 to 1, and subtract 8 from the remaining decimal value 9, which equals 1. The only bit value that will go into 1 is 1. So we need to set the bit representing 1 to 1. And we've successfully converted our decimal number 41 to binary, which is 101001. And we can check this is correct by adding together the bit values set to on. 32 plus 8 plus 1 equals 41. One area where binary and decimal values can cause confusion is when dealing with larger numbers, such as thousands, 1k. In binary, 1024 is abbreviated as 1k. In the decimal system, 1k is simply 1000, not 1024. And it's important to be aware of this discrepancy, because it can make a difference. Hardware specifications can be expressed in different terms. And partitioning disks is another example. Binary is at the heart of all aspects of computing. It's not something that's just confined to the maths classroom or the hardware designer's workshop. For example, when networking, you need to know your binary in order to calculate IP addresses and do things like subnetting. And if you're new to the field of computer science, binary is the building block of the computer. Well, I hope you found this video helpful and it's got you thinking about binary. Please subscribe to the ITTaster channel. Your comments are welcome and thanks very much for watching.